Bills, Saints on EA Sports. We welcome you to New Orleans, Louisiana for today's game.
I don't know which team has the better tight end, but I do know that that could very well be the difference in this game today.
Well, if you made me choose between the two, I'll tell you what. I'll just say you take one. I don't care who you take. I'll take the other one because they're both that good. They can do it all. As I say, you hear me say it every once in a while. They're all in one. That means they can do anything you want.
Spiller takes his spot in the backfield. First down at the 22. As the grab. Breaks away. Good yardage picked up on that call.
Now, if you want to keep your place on the offense, then catch the pass and break a tackle and get some extra yards. That's what the guy did on that play. Nice job by him.
First down on the way. Breeze in shotgun formation. Cooks is going to pull in the bullet pass.
They bring him down at the 41-yard line.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Breeze back in shotgun formation. Surveys. That's dropped by Colston, who couldn't bring it in.
One player that Drew Brees loves to find across the middle is Marcus Colston.
Yeah, Marcus Colston reminds me a lot of a guy like Anquan Boldin. All you need is a little hope. Throw the football to them because they're big and strong. They attack it, and they can make those catches with defensive backs all over.
The Saints now move the chains. The 31. Here we go. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Breeze with the handoff. Williams, the one who made the big stop.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play and they stopped it.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Drew Brees has it under center. They'll call on the services of C.J. Spiller. Here's a look at the defensive starters and a good look at the secondary, a group that could be the difference in this game today.
Spiller in the backfield, single back set.
Three-step drop. Intercepted.
You got to try to avoid this as a quarterback. Don't throw off that back foot unless you have to. When you do, there's just no way you're going to be as good if you had good balance. That time the throw's off the mark.
Not enough leg with that one.
Well, next week they might be trying kickers out when they go home because they did not expect to miss that field goal. It comes up way short.
The Saints set at the line. Dime package. The Bills will take the snap from the 35.
A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Harmon's got it. First down.
When you run the slant route, it's very important to know as a receiver that you're going to catch that football probably in between some linebackers.
First down following the long play.
The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
Throws the pass. Makes the catch in open space. In the red zone. First down here after the completion. Taylor's standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Same. Touchdown, Buffalo. That's a big way to get the momentum in your favor with that touchdown, Phil.
Yeah, nothing like it. Midway through the first quarter, you're on top of the other team, and you just feel like, hey, we got things under control, and you're putting pressure on the opposition to go out there and try to make something happen.
The Saints getting set to return the kickoff. No return as this goes for a touchback. First down at the 20. Benjamin Watson makes the grab. They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. Breeze going to take it from the gun. He'll throw it over the middle. That's dropped by Colston, who couldn't bring it in.
Got to give this secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
The Saints snap it at the 41. Methodically, he just throws it away.
Well, the defense has got to be happy about this situation. Anytime early in the game you get an offense at third and long, you are looking to make a play and get things rolling on your side.
The Bills with two extra defensive backs in the dime. Stands in the pocket. Looking long. The ball is jarred loose. They've come out of the blocks fairly sluggishly. And this defense has taken full advantage, Phil.
Yeah, the offense having a tough time. They did not have a good series that time. And the defense, you're right, took advantage of a sluggish offense and got off the field.
Offense back on the field here for this 4th and 10 play. The Saints snapping at the 41. The Saints turn the ball over on downs.
Well, every defense is looking for somebody to sack the quarterback, and that time the speed of the defensive end gets around the tackle and gets the sack.
The Bills offense preparing to get this drive underway. Their last drive actually ended in a touchdown, Phil. We'll see if they still have it in them to issue a repeat performance.
Well, what you saw in that last drive was everything just came together perfectly for them. The experience of the football team, the talent of the players, and the coaches helped them out and got it done.
Wants to go deep.
One player to watch on this Buffalo offense is running back LeSean McCoy. One of the most talked about trades in the offseason, picked up from Philadelphia, Phil.
Yeah, I like the trade. Look, you're Rex Ryan. What do you want to do on the offensive side? You want to run the football, and why not?
They're going to get him here for a sack.
That's what all defensive coordinators love to see. When they don't have the blitz, and one of their defensive linemen gets a sack without any blitzing.
Taylor's alone in the backfield. And he takes off. That's a good tackle, and that's a quick three and out. The Bills come to the line. The first down marker is at the 24. The Bills take it from the 28. two hands on the football and has the catch.
The Saints might have been caught off guard there on that fourth down play.
Well, why? Why would you be caught off guard in a situation like this? You always have to be ready on the defensive side. That time they were not.
Now first and 10. Looking across the middle. Touchdown, Bills. Late in the first quarter, and they're stretching their lead out. It looks like they have it in their minds to put this game away early.
Well, that's what they're trying to do, isn't it? They just want to get it over with early, just put all doubt, remove all doubt, I should say, from the opponents that you're in for a rough day, and you might as well just give up.
Murphy's running this one out. Williams, the one who brings him to the ground. That return's good for about 23. The Saints have to still be thinking about what happened on their last possession as they get ready to start this next one.
Well, how can the offensive players have confidence? They're thinking, man, well, how's this game going to be managed? We can be in any situation, and we're going to go for it. It's just crazy. It's bad. It's not smart. And you just got to play better.
You wonder where the threshold point is from your own side of the 50. I'm fourth and 30, is it? Fourth and 35. At what point do you decide to go punt the football?
I think it's quite evident there's no threshold. They're going to go for it no matter what.
Second down now. Playing press coverage to the outside. We'll have one more play before the quarter expires. Second down and 10.
And intercepted. We're just off Poydras Street here in New Orleans, and not even a mile away from the heart of the French Quarter at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Catches the ball on the sideline, but does not get both feet down. Taylor's got no one behind him. Just a quarterback waiting for the snap. Knocked down as he fires it.
Third ball coming up. You're losing by a couple scores. You're on the defensive side. You must know the offense is not going to take a chance. So be aggressive and maybe get lucky and get a turnover.
Third down and 10. Percy Harvin with the grab.
Good job by the defense, staying in the right spots. They give up the short pass. They make the tackle, and now we have fourth down coming up.
The offense back out on the field here for this fourth and short play. Taylor's set. Everybody emptied out for this snap. Out of the pocket. Fights through that hit.
Good job that time by the offense. They pick up a first down inside the 20-yard line. Now we'll see if they can punch it in and get 7 points.
This next play will take place at the 11. Quarters formation here for the defense. First down and 10. Running right through the trenches. Taylor's tackled down after a gain of 10.
If I'm on the defense and the offense is this close to scoring, I'll tell you what I'm doing. I am sending everybody. I am going to gamble that it is a run. If they have the courage to throw it, let them. If they do, of course it'll be a touchdown.
Bills are in the end zone. Touchdown. Taylor's got his third touchdown of the game. Another touchdown early in the second quarter. And Phil, we met with this team and the coaches. Did you have any idea they were going to come out with this kind of start?
No, I didn't, Jim. They're doing a terrific job on the offensive side and scoring those points. I love what they're doing on the defensive side. Hey, when it's not working, you know what you do? You change game plans. That's what I want to see from the defense.
Murphy's going to test the coverage this time. And they crash into him, ending the return at the 20-yard line. The Saints just gave up some big turnover points.
Let's see if they can hold on to the football this time, Phil, because we know how crucial it is. We talked to the coaches about it this week. This was their concern with this team.
Well, if you want to stay on the field, you better quit turning it over, right, Jim? That's what the coaches look. You make mistakes on the field, they're gonna be forgiving to a point, but you gotta be.
Darius takes down the quarterback.
Looks like they're in press coverage here.
Spiller's got it on the screen. This is third down. The Saints get set at the line, needing to get to the 30 for a first. Hill has the catch. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. Quick drop back. The Saints turn the ball over on downs.
The Saints go for it on fourth down, and they do not get it done. Now it's up to their defense to bail them out.
The Bills' offense heading back onto the field to start the drive after the result of their last possession was a touchdown. You think they've got another one in them, partner?
Oh, I absolutely do. I mean, just look at it. They got a good football team. The quarterback has great confidence and talent, and you put those things together, that makes you good. It makes you dangerous, and I wouldn't be surprised to see them march down there again. Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Trying to find his target over the middle, but that pass goes incomplete. Second down coming up. Taylor's all by himself in the backfield for this snap. Snap it out of the gun. Taylor's on the move.
Look up at that scoreboard. You lead the football game, so we have a third and long situation. So you've got to know that. Manage the game. Don't take a chance.
The Bills come to the line of scrimmage and empty out the backfield. Everyone split out wide. The margin is increased with another touchdown. Amazing execution midway in the second quarter as they're pulling away.
Yeah, I've been so impressed what they've been doing on both sides of the football here today. And the coach has got to be so happy with what they see from their players. They're executing the plays just as they drew them up.
Murphy's going to test the coverage here. And he's tackled right at the 30-yard line after that return.
The Saints take the field here. Their last possession ended with the very crazy decision of going for it on fourth down from their own territory. An unusual decision, to say the least.
I don't know if it's unusual. We see this all the time from this guy. So it's when you're going to learn. You know, I guess when you pile up enough losses, you'll finally say, hey, I want to win a game. I'm going to manage it differently. And in those situations, you should punt.
Okay, if you were playing the game right now, what would you have done with that last possession?
I absolutely.
Marcel Darius with the sack.
Well, you expect defensive ends to get sacks because they come around the outside. But when you get pressure from the inside and the defensive tackle gets a sack, that's just an added bonus.
Loss of four on the play. Third and 12 to go. On the money.
Good job by the defense. They're well taught, well schooled by the defensive coordinator. They know in situations like this, if it's thrown short of the first down marker, they're good. They come up, make the tackle. Now we have fourth down.
Breeze is going to take it from the shotgun. Breeze running away from the pressure. Breeze will slide here and end the play.
It's a rough game out there. Avoid hits at all costs. Good job that time by the quarterback sliding before he takes the hit.
What a nice spot to begin this drive.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Taylor's got it in the gun. Should have had it.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
Second down.
Come on, let's go.
The D-lines, they're seeing something on the offensive side. Everybody shifting to their left.
Harmon can't bring it in. That'll probably go as a drop.
I'll say this. If you're in a situation like this, third long, and you're winning here, if you throw the football, fire the coach. And I'm just saying that because I don't think there's any chance they're going to throw the football in this situation.
No bump coverage here. Corners backing up. Percy Harvin has the catch. Tackle's made, and that'll move the chains. That's his sixth catch of the day. 2 minutes to go in the first half and a first down. And we've reached the two-minute warning in this one.
Coming to the line at the 27.
First and 10. Cameron Jordan hunts him down and makes him pay.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit here. You want to stop the offense from scoring here with under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Good pressure on the quarterback, and they take him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Tabor's taking off. This will be incomplete. He was trying to find Harmon.
Taylor's able to get outside the pocket that time, and it's a good job getting outside the pocket, but there's nowhere to throw it. The pass is incomplete.
Taylor's ready for the snap. Empty backfield. The Bills will take the snap from the 35. Taylor's gonna scramble. The coach is going to go for it. The Saints defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. Goodwin's got the catch and the first.
This offense has been moving the football all day long. Once again in the red zone, they have a big lead. What will they do? I think they'll just try to run it in from here.
And the catch is made by Percy Harvin. And that's a gain of 10.
Well, when you got a big lead and you're down near the opposing team's goal line, what do you do? Well, you know what? You line up, you run the football, and just dare the defense. Can you stop us this time, even though you know we're going to run it?
McCoy. And that gains one.
Jim, the defense gives up the first down that time inside the red zone. But there's only so many things the offense can do. Let's see if they can hold them.
Breaking huddle at the four. First and goal.
Nowhere to go as this will be a loss of three. The Saints have to call one right here, and they do, and they are out of timeouts. Press coverage all the way.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
It was right there, but he didn't bring it in.
Jim, I just want to say this to the quarterback. It's third and goal. If the play's not there, throw it away. Do not force the action.
Third and goal from the 7. Taylor is on the move. Kenny Vaccaro in on the interception. They needed something to happen before halftime, and they come up with the play with the pick.
And they got what they needed, a dumb decision, a terrible decision by the coach. My gosh, you're dominating the game. You're winning. Why would you throw it? I don't know, but that was a terrible mistake.
Brown's there to take him down. No time to waste. They hurry to the line. Second down and 2. Breeze on the move. Launches it down the field. Snatches it with one hand. And in for the touchdown. How big was that touchdown right before halftime, Phil? They were getting blown out most of this half.
Jim, that was so big right before halftime. And I can compare it like this. It's about the size of your ego. That's how big it is, man, because we know Jim Nance loves some Jim Nance.
Harvin on the return. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line.
The Bills offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points. Hartman's really hit hard that time. And I know the football hit his hands, but when a defender times it perfectly like that, with that much power and speed going into that receiver, you are going to let that football go. That's human nature. Really good job by the defensive player.
Second and 10. The Bills get a first down.
There's no doubt time of possession can be an overrated stat in games many times. But one thing you want to do, throw and catch it just like this to pick up those first downs and keep it going.
After the long gain, let's see what they do here.
Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
Taylor's going to take off with it.
Taylor's athletic enough to get out of the pocket. That's a really good job by him. But you have to give the defense a lot of credit. They shut down all the receivers.
The Bills are at the line of scrimmage with a spread formation. Down the field, makes the catch deep down the middle of the field.
Jim, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. You're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up.
Well, I tell you, it's getting ugly out here. Phil, they add another touchdown here at the start of the third. And have you ever heard of a mercy rule in the NFL?
Yeah, no, I don't think there's anything such as a mercy rule. But if there was, they would call it off right here, wouldn't they, Jim? But hey, look, what a job at halftime. They wanted to keep things moving in the right direction. They have done that, and, man, what an awesome display by the offense.
Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Saints talked things over at the intermission, and I'm sure one of the first orders of business was to try to figure out a way to get this offense going, Phil.
Absolutely. That's what you want to do, and I think you do that by play call. So the coach,
and he's intercepted. Tackles made.
You thought maybe this offense would have come out of the locker room a little more focused, Phil, but they come out and continue with their mistakes, this time a pick.
I think they have the focus, Jim. I just think it's the fact that they're playing a very good football team. This offense, they're young. They need more experience. So just keep playing, and times will get better.
Line of scrimmage, the 27.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
Watkins got it on a pass that had some heat.
All right, coaches, don't get greedy. Be decisive over there on the sideline. Do what's best for your football team. Keep getting those first downs and letting that clock just keep running. You got a big lead here in the second half. Don't take any chances.
First and 10. Has Watkins. Brought down by Williams.
Receivers get scared sometimes running that slant route. They know their linebackers inside running towards them because they're watching the quarterback's eyes.
From the shotgun. That's dropped by Watkins, who couldn't bring it in.
Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, he can make a big play.
The Bills lined up. Everybody split out wide. Taylor's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Brought down by Williams.
If you give him the chance, he will run the football. That's what he did that time. He tucked it in there and ran up the field and got a few yards.
Taylor's back in shotgun formation. Pass is intercepted. Into the open. He's in the clear. The 40, the 30, the 20, tackle's made.
The defense has some fight in them, even though this game's probably out of reach.
Well, they do. They got some pride. That's what it takes. That's why you're in the league. You're a good player who has pride, and you never give up. The defense didn't do that. They went out there and got the interception, and I'll say this to the offense. Let's keep playing. We'll see what happens late in this game.
And they are in on Spiller. Time for the hurry-up offense. Just a quick drop back. And this goes incomplete. Breeze can't connect.
Well, these are the kind of throws in the NFL, Jim. You just take for granted that if it's open, you are going to hit it. But the quarterback makes a big mistake, leads the receiver too far to the inside, and it goes incomplete.
C.J. Spiller picks up out two.
Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do, just keep picking up those first downs. We hope it
forces it across for the touchdown.
You got to give the offensive line just a lot of credit. It's first and goal. They just line up and power the football in there. Nice run, but a great job by the O-line.
The Bills are ready to return the kickoff. He'll take it from the four. And the tackle's made right around the 26-yard line.
The Bills' offense back on the field, trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
Getting set as fast as they can. Second down, three to go. LeSean McCoy takes the handoff. Now looking at third down. The Bills will set up. The 36 is the first down line. Taylor is standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. And that's going to be a three and out.
Well, the defense has got to love that. They love it when a quarterback is uneasy for whatever reason or just not in rhythm. That time they see him throw off the back foot, and the throw goes incomplete.
The Bills from the 32. The Bills turn the ball over on downs.
The Bills here to... winning the football game, I don't understand why you would go for it on fourth down. They go for it, and it doesn't work.
The Saints take the field again on offense. They'll be looking for a repeat of their last drive. They came away with a touchdown and really had the defense on its heels.
Well, it's going to be hard to repeat what they just did because it looked so easy, and it was well done by their offense. And I think when you talk about situations like this, it really comes down to one thing. Can the offensive line continue to dominate? Anytime your team is down, you're inside the other team's red zone, you look for one of your star players, your quarterback, wide receiver, or running back.
Touchdown, and that'll close the gap in this one.
Tight ends are becoming a bigger and bigger part in the passing offense in the NFL. It leads to a touchdown this time. Nice job by the big guy just getting in position to make the catch.
The Saints are ready to kick it away. Able to move past the 20 and brought. Down at
the 23. The Bills back out there on offense. Their last drive, they had fourth down on their own side of midfield. They decided to go for it. Instead of punting the football away, we both were wondering why.
Oh, man, some people just never learn. They keep going for it on fourth down and they're in their own territory. And it always backfires. And what do you expect? Well, I know what you can expect, another loss. You just got to be smart with your decision-making when you're managing a football game.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage.
Dixon's taking the handoff.
He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
That's a nice play at that time by the offense, getting the first down. They're up here in the second half, and they're moving the football. That's a great feeling.
An extra tight end on the field for this one.
The final quarter begins with this snap. Harvin's there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it. He's brought down at the 20-yard line.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion.
This play set up by the long gainer.
Buffalo in for the score. Goodwin's second touchdown of the game.
Nice throw by the quarterback that time. Put it right on the money. Not a big window. It doesn't matter to him today. Great control of the football. Put it right in there for the touchdown.
Murphy's going to run this one out. And he fails to get out to the 20. And he is smacked down at the 15-yard line.
The Saints on a quest for their third straight scoring drive here, Phil. They've been having their way with that defense on these last few possessions.
Well, let me say this, Jim. It's not that easy to score points in the NFL. Not the way they're making it look. And they're confident. They look like they're fast. They're fresh. They're rested. It's been fun to watch.
They're going to the hurry-up offense, and they're back to the line quickly.
Breeze going to take it from the gun.
Looking at every option. Great grab there. Snags it with one hand.
What must it be like to be able to go down there and make a play like that? How about it? One-handed catch. That was special.
That long gain sets them up here on this play.
C.J. Spiller. Darius in on the tackle.
They hurry to the line of scrimmage.
He'll take the snap from the gun. Catch made. That's a gain of 7.
The Saints understand, just get whatever yards you can every time you run a play. That's what they do that time. It's a short completion, but look what position it puts them here. In on third down, this is something they can handle.
Breeze now completed 4 in a row.
Good job by the offense getting the first down in the red zone. Now becomes tricky. Can you deceive the defense where you get a chance to get a score?
First and goal from the 9. Breeze on the move. Touchdown, and they cut into that lead.
Anytime the offense is near the goal line, you've got to be alert for the quarterback moving and trying to run with the football. Nobody on the defense is watching the quarterback, and he just scrambles in easily for the touchdown.
And unable to pull off the onside kick, the hands team comes away with the football.
The Bills' offense coming back onto the field. It was a good drive for them the last time they had it, all the way down to the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah, you know, in this game, Jim, it's all about momentum. And when you feel you got the momentum on your side, you got to take advantage of it. So now I think it's up to the offensive coordinator to call the right plays.
The Bills have it at the 44. Throws the pass. Goodwin's met at the 37.
They're going to the hurry. Back to the line now.
The Bills from the 37.
Looking to go down the field here. He brings it in.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Tabers, now the defense gets a sack.
You got to be quick and decisive when you're down near the goal line and you're throwing the pass as a quarterback. That time he was not, and he takes a huge sack.
Taylor's got it in the gun.
scanning the field. He's drilled as he throws.
Tim, I love these situations. Third and goal, what are they going to call? They're going to run the football, they're going to go with a pass, and if it is a pass, I would look for something quick.
The Bills all bunched up here as they get set at the line.
Third down and 11.
Makes the reception. Bills in for the score. Goodwin's got his third touchdown of the game.
Well, how many times can we say it, Jim? Another touchdown pass by the quarterback. He is, he is really on. He is feeling it. When they get open, he is making terrific throws.
Murphy's running this one out. That returns good for about 33.
Playing press coverage to the outside.
Here we go.
The Saints take it from the 28. They'll call on the services of C.J. Spiller. They're able to move the chains after that last run. Spiller's going to secure the handle. Gains five. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Breeze from the shotgun. Going deep. And it falls incomplete.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
The Saints are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. Third and five. Breaks free. Scans the field. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. The Saints will go for it here on fourth down and a short yardage situation. 2 minutes to go in the second half. C.J. Spiller is in the backfield. Got a flag. Coming to the line at the 48. Thought I saw a little flinch right there, and it's going to push the offense back 5 yards. The Saints come out with a split backfield. Breeze going to take the snap from the shotgun. It's caught by Benjamin Watson. That's a gain of 10.
You can only take what the defense gives you. Even though the offense is down here in the fourth quarter, they throw it short. That was a smart play. Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
Breeze connects with Colston. First down coming up. Timeout won't be used here. They'll go to the hurry. Breeze back in shotgun formation. Hooks. And that's a touchdown. And they inch closer.
Well, Jim, it's almost impossible to guard these guys nowadays as they go down the field. These wide receivers, they have feet like ballerinas. And even though you get tight coverage, they're so quick, they can get open and make the catches.
There is a flag out. Everything hinged on them recovering that onside kick, and they failed to do so.
Well, Jim, when you're doing the onside kick, you really got to hope for that perfect bounce of the football. That time it did not happen. That's why they didn't recover.
Taylor standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Gains 16. The Bills have created chances for themselves in the passing attack today.
Taylor's been unstoppable so far.
He has been unstoppable, hasn't he? And when your quarterback is hot, keep giving the football to him. They've done it, and he has rewarded the coaches.
Second and 10 coming up. Taylor's alone in the backfield. Drop back, shotgun formation. He'll throw it over the middle. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab. They'll go right to the hurry up. Won't use a timeout here. All the way home just in time. A late touchdown.
And we're going to have a stoppage here because the booth wants to have a look at this potential touchdown. The Bills getting set now for the extra point.
The point after try is in the books. The Saints getting set to return the kickoff. Murphy's going to test the coverage this time. And they have him covered up and bring him down inside of the 15. The Saints take the field on offense. They have been manhandled here throughout today, Phil. And what can they take out of these last few minutes that could be positive for them?
Well, you know, Jim, in a situation like this, there's really nothing you can do now that's going to make you feel better or give you something to carry over into next week. So don't be looking for it. Try to end the game and just know today the team on the other side beat you up and they were the better team.
The Saints still trail, but as we look at the passing numbers, it's hard to find much fault with them. Breeze numbers, though, speak to a team that could be winning if other things like their defense were doing their part here, partner.
Well, yeah, that's right. The defense has got to hold their end up, but the offense, they've been very, very good. The quarterback has been accurate. He has been smart, and that always gives you a chance when your quarterback is playing that well.
Graham's in on the tackle.
Well, they call it the post route because you're running towards the goal post. But a good route that time by the receiver, making that cut. He gets open, gets behind the defense, and a nice throw.
Now first and 10. He's got the catch. Williams is there to make the tackle. The Saints call a timeout and are left now with only one. Breeze in shotgun formation. Breeze on the move. Third down now.
Ready.
Breeze is going to take it from the shotgun. Almost intercepted.
Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down.
Trying to fight through right up the middle of the field.
First down by the offense inside the red zone. Can the defense show them something different here and keep them from scoring a touchdown?
First and goal. He runs with it right up the gut. Breeze tackled down after a gain of two.
Well, that last play almost got him in here. And when you look at this, what do they do? Well, you just want to punch it in. There's a lot of different scenarios. You could do a play-action fake, probably get somebody wide open, or have a running back just jump over the top for the touchdown.
Bills defense now is going to go nickel. Second and goal from the two. Breeze on the move. And he's sacked. And that should do it. They won't get another playoff here. For Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nance saying so long.